us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord
because of her insecurity.
Word from the Lord.
That's why I married Sister Etar. She was a secure woman. A secure woman. She was secure. And she believes enough in herself and enough in me not to be concerned about any other woman. And ministry can be done. As a matter of fact, she helps me with ministry.
All right.
Hello? Yeah. But if she was insecure, she wouldn't be able to help me. And when you are insecure in God, you are like that insecure woman every instant that happens. Oh, I got a headache. Oh, it's brain cancer. Insecure. Everything is a big problem. Everything is a big trial.
Well,
insecure. Oh, but when you become secure in God, you can get the eviction notice and still believe that God is going to answer your prayer.
All right, I know you're right. All right.
And believe that God will not fail. He's never failed me yet, as the old folks say. Oh, you can get that second notice and that turnoff notice and not know where the money's going to come from. But if you're secure in God, you'll believe that God is going to make a way somehow. Because you are so secure in God that it seems like most of the time, oh, especially Christians, when we end up in the dark, they become afraid. Mm. You see, when you're in the dark, that's really when you need to be secure. That's really what faith is all about. Faith is not just for the mountaintop. Faith is meant to get you through the valley.
That's right.
That's why the psalmist can say, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, hey, I'm secure in God. I'm not going to fear no evil because I know my God can save me. My God can keep me safe. That's and right. I'm secure in Him. Give somebody a hand of praise. Give God a hand of praise. Are you secure in God? Oh, you like some of these people that are running around like Chicken Little, thinking the sky is falling. Mm-hmm. Or putting your faith in people that you should.
Yeah.
Mama's going to help me. Mm. Daddy's going to help me. I tell you, there's going to come a time in your life where you realize that mama and daddy don't have enough resources.
That's right. That's right. Right.
Yeah.
Her mama and daddy mad at me and then cut me off. And there I say, God wants you to have the audacity to have faith in Him. This person said, the will of God will never take you to where the grace of God will not protect you.
Thank you, Lord.
Are you secure in God? Yeah. There I say, He's the only one that you should be secure in.
All right.
Because everything else in our country and in our nation is fickle. They're praising Obama right now.
Hmm. Well,
but you let those economics not be right in 4 years from now. You let that you let things not change. Hmm.
Well,
be like Jesus. 1 week, they were saying, Hosanna, Hosanna, to the highest. Oh, that was his inaugural day. Hosanna, Hosanna, to the highest. Oh, they put him in that Cadillac. Called that donkey, it was a colt. Hosanna, Hosanna. And the next week, crucify him, crucify him. Tried to give him a way out. No, we want Jesus. Crucify him. Don't put your confidence in people.
That's right.
Right.
Have have the audacity to have faith in God. Because I believe that God is the only one that can save our nation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I believe the president is going to do the best that he can. That's what I think he said in the paper. And he's going to do the best that he can, but it's just not just dependent upon him.
All right.
He got a whole lot of other knuckleheads that got something to prove. That want to be in his place that he has to deal with. But tonight we want us as the people of God to have audacity, to have faith in God.
Amen.
And believe that he can take care of us right now. I got needs right now. I don't have time to wait for things to change. I got bills right now. I'm sick right now. My marriage is failing right now. Hello? I'm struggling trying to overcome drugs, alcohol, and cigarettes right now. I need help right now.
Right now.
And God says in his word tonight that he can save. Not only can he keep you saved, but he can keep you safe.
Yeah.
Some of you are coming out of some great struggles. God is saying that I can keep you safe.
Yeah.
But you've got to have security in me. Yeah. Say to your neighbor, neighbor!
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor!
Oh, neighbor!
Have!
Have!
Audacity.
Audacity.
To have faith.
To have faith.
In God.
In God.
In Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
Well, tonight, for many of us who have fast and pray, this time of prayer will be the end of our fasting and praying. As we stood on the word of God, who says that politics is not what's needed to change a recession.
Well,
right.
Repentance
of God's people is the thing that is needed.
Yes, sir.
For revival.
Yes, sir.
Right.
And tonight, as we end this fast, we're going to pray to that end. Not only that, we're going to pray for Brother Carl. He said he had a heart attack. Audrey's brother, that's where Brother Bill and Sister Audrey is. We're going to pray for the safe travel of those who will be traveling. I know Kim and Brother Al's on their way back from Washington. Pray for Brother Jackson, who's going to be on the road as well, possibly. Also, we're going to pray for the house. We believe that it will be ready by the first week of this month. And we
next month, February.
And we're going to pray that God will send the right person to take occupancy of the house. Stewardship unto God's properties. We're going to pray also. We're supposed to pray for our church. You know, I'm praying for revival within our congregation.
Yes.
All
yes.
right.
All right. But we need revival.
Yes, we do.
But again, it comes through repentance. Mm-hmm. We're praying for those that are in the box, and that only. They only comes to the house through repentance.
Yes, sir.
And that's how revival comes. So we're praying for our church and all those who are seated tonight that may have unspoken prayer requests. We're praying for our leaders also, new leaders. And we're praying for the new changes. There are going to be some changes, and you need to get ready. That's going to happen. But we believe that God is who he says he is. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Shall we pray? Father, Father God, we come tonight, Lord, wanting to thank you and to praise your holy name, Father. To thank you.
Another calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.